Hello buddies, I'm Nonit and today we will talk about the deep ocean mission. On 16th June, the cabinet approves the long pending the deep ocean mission to develop the submersible vehicle that will allow a crew. Means there is a submersible manned vehicle and that is a crew, means the manned crew which will go into the ocean and to plunge this 600 meter into the ocean and hunt the floor of to find the precious metal include the actually the polymetallic nodule. So this is the precious metal this through this deep ocean mission will be find. So if India successfully work this or work in such a way that India will be in the handful of countries and which has done like the USA, UK, France, Russia, Japan and two Asian giants, actually the Japan and the China. So India will be in the top ranks and will be included in these kinds of countries which had done in this. Another main important point, which is the nodal ministry under which this deep ocean mission will work. So remember that is the Ministry of Earth Sciences, not Ministry of Science and Technology or Ministry of Energy, but the Ministry of Earth Sciences. So what is the main aim? The main aim is basically to explore the ocean, to basically explore the deep ocean and ocean just like ISRO, what is doing in this space, because ISRO is exploring the space, so just like deep ocean mission is that, and that's why this is the explore the ocean just done in the space. So in how many years it will complete? It is a 5-year plan. Remember that it is a 5-year plan in two phases. First phases, and if you are talk about the expenditure, then expenditure is 4077 crore rupees, and in the first phase, which include the 2021 to 2024, so it includes the 2828.4 crore, and second phase in 2024 to 2026 is the 1301.1 crore. As far as the area where this exploration or where the deep ocean mission will apply, what is the area? So area covered is the 25,000 square kilometer of Central Indian Ocean Basin. For this is the India, then here is the Maldives somewhere, then here is the deep exploration and the Central Indian Ocean Basin where the exploration will take place. This area has been given by the International Seabird Authority of United Nations. So this should be remembered. So let's talk about the six components of the deep ocean mission. So this is the six component under which the whole deep ocean mission will lie. So first is the manned crew. So what will manned crew will do? It will actually, there is the man. So man will be in the crew and that will go into the meter of the 6,000 meter deep in the ocean to search the floor of the ocean. And another is the integrated mining system. What will this integrated mining system will do? And it will find the polymetallic nodule. So this is the polymetallic nodule. So what is the polymetallic nodule? Includes the iron, cobalt, manganese, zinc, etc. So this integrated mining system will do this. Another is the very important is the ocean climate change advisory services. So this will actually provide the information related to the whatever happened in the deep sea floor. Another is very very important is the searching for the deep sea flora and fauna. So this searching for the deep sea flora and fauna will do include the microbes. So what will that? There is a sustainable use of these resources comes under this searching for deep sea flora and fauna. Another is the identify potential sources of precious metal. So under this potential sources, where is the actually the precious metal? Are there, so this will find under this component. Another component is the studying and preparing the detailed engineering design. Detailed engineering design is comes in thermal engineering. So thermal engineering services. So thermal engineering conversion and desalinization plant. So as you know, India needs the water, more and more water. So we need the desalinization plant. And it will also energy kind of conversion will take place through this finding. So it will help in this area. Another is the finding the expert in the field of ocean biology and engineering. How this component will help? This will component will help in the application, means the practical use in the industrial sector and whatever in the we can use the knowledge of the deep ocean mission. Through this finding of expert, or if we hire the expert and find the expert, then the expert will apply this in the industrial sector and basically the application will take place of this deep ocean mission. So now let's talk about the significance of this deep ocean mission. If you know, according to some reports that India's energy requirement will be doubled by 2040 around or 2050. So if this Indian Ocean research can meet the energy requirement of India for the next 100 years, this is the most significant of this deep Indian Ocean mission. So second, it will that ki, as you know, to counter China, India need to hold the grip or increase the grip in the Indian Ocean. So to increase the grip, it will deep Indian Ocean mission through research, exploration, etc. It will also hold the or increase the grip of the India in Indian Ocean too, and it will also help to countering the China. Another is that if exploration of metals will take place, if exploration of metals will take place and some most important and other resources found in the ocean, then it will also reduce resources and it will also reduce dependence on China. As you know, we are heavily importing from China, including the metals and other equipment. Other is the important, if you talk about the SDG 14, Sustainable Development Goal 14, then it promotes the blue economy. So it's blue economy related to the blue economy. So blue economy related to the SDG 14 will also generate, and it will generate the opportunities for the employment and lead to more expertise in this field of the Indian Ocean. Now let's talk about the challenges. So challenges of the deep ocean mission. So remember that the NASA oceanographer Carl Feldman. So Carl Feldman would said that at great depths there is a zero visibility and extremely cold temperature and the pressure, which actually hinders the exploration of the deep ocean mission. And this is the one of the most popular reason why the exploration and why the research is not going in the deep ocean mission. Another, you can say that the technology. As you know, India is a technology deficit country even today. So even the what is the on the surface or what is the on the surface, India is not able to cope up with that because of the lack of technology. Other is the lack of expert. So lack of expert may deter the application of the findings of the deep ocean mission either in the industrial use or etc. Another is the threats to flora and fauna. As you know, if you talk about the reefs, so they are continuously declining, and with the help of some technologies now they are getting to revive. So these are the some challenges related to the deep ocean mission. But what should be the way forward? India should go with ahead of the deep ocean mission, because it will not only counter the China, which is the very strategic point, but it can also meet the energy requirement of India. And it will reduce the dependence on China, especially in the field of metal. And if the more will explore, so we can also export. We can explore, also export. So these are the some way forward. Thank you guys. Hope you like this video. You should subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.